Yesterday, we have studied about Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam in the chapter, My Childhood. We have studied that he has given various examples of communal harmony where he was living in Rameshwaram, and his all the three friends of his childhood friends, they were from strict or from orthodox Brahmin families, naming Shiv Prakashan, Ramanand Shastri, and Aravindam. But he is saying that his childhood was also filled with the stories of prophet as well as from Lord Rama. It means that in his family also there was not any kind of discrimination that he has ever faced. But then he has given an example when he faced discrimination for the first time. As in the paragraph number 6, we have studied about an experience when he was studying in Rameshwaram temple. So when he was studying in Rameshwaram temple, what he has felt or what he has faced was that an elementary teacher, when he entered new to the school, he told APJ Abdul Kalam to get separated from Ramanand Shastri, as usually he was sitting with Ramanand Shastri. And they were sitting at the front desk, but recognizing him as a Muslim boy, he told him to go to the last desk according to the prevalent system at that time. So what happened? This really made a deep mark in his mind as well as in his heart that why he was separated. Moreover, they also have to face certain kind of discriminations. So even his friend Ramanand Shastri, he also felt very bad, and he was utterly downcast as he was shifted to the last seat in the row. And this image of weeping of his friend, it is still remembered by him, and it leaves a lasting impression in his mind. So let us see in the paragraph number 7 that what will happen next. After school, we went home and told our respected parents about the incidents, which still students are still entering. So I don't know why they are late. Khwaish Nanda, I don't know why he has entered here in this room. Just a moment. So, after school, we went home and told our respected parents about the incident. Naturally, when the child is filled with sorrow and he is about to cry at every point, they will find nobody to share their feelings with. They will talk to their parents, as during that time there existed a strong bond between the families. Children were used to talk to their parents about each and every happening that is occurring to them, and they were talking about whatever the incidents they were suffering from so that they can find out a solution for that. And even these days also, what I have observed is that the children, they used to talk to parents if something wrong happened in the school, because they don't find anywhere else a secure place where to talk with. They feel that ultimately it is only parents who will sort out the matter. Similarly, they talk to their parents that whatever the case was. Lakshman Shastri summoned the teacher in our presence. So, and told the teacher that he should not spread the poison of social inequality and communal intolerance in the minds of innocent children. So Ramanand Shastri's father, Pakshi Lakshman Shastri, he has called the teacher and in front of the children and rebuked him and told him that he should not sow the seeds of difference among them. They are, you can say, they are blank papers. Whatever you write over them, ultimately, it will be etched in their minds forever. So here we are living in Rameshwaram state, where there is not existing any kind of discrimination, And ultimately, you should not develop this kind of hatred, differences, discrimination among the minds of young children. You should not make them feel communal differences. And do not spread the poison of social inequality and communal intolerance. Communal intolerance means differences in various communities to the minds of these innocent children. He bluntly asked the teacher to either apologize or quit the school and the island. So he has put two options in front of the teacher. Either you feel sorry or cut a sorry figure in front of children, but for whatever you have done, or you would leave the island forever and the school also. But that was not at all, you can say, adaptable to the teacher. Why he should leave his job? Not only did the teacher regret his behavior, but the strong sense of conviction, conviction means firm belief, but the strong sense of conviction Lakshman Shastri conveyed ultimately reformed this young teacher. So the teacher, he did not only regret for the act that he has done, but ultimately he has also, you can say, he has also with strong conviction, with firm, you can say, approach of belief, he has made the teacher believe that he should not spread this kind of poison in the island. And moreover, he reformed means he changed his mind. And for after that, this kind of incident never happened with APJ Abdul Kalam as well as his friends. So, on the whole, the small society of Rameshwaram was very rigid in terms of the segregation of different social groups. So actually, what he is saying, that small society of Rameshwaram, it was rigid in its beliefs. It was actually, although Lakshman Shastri, he told not to spread this kind of poison, but actually what it is, this society, it was separated, it was segregated in different social groups. How? Let us see an example. However, my science teacher, Shiva Subramaniam Iyer, though an orthodox Brahmin with a very conservative wife, he was something of a rebel. He did his best to break the social barriers so that people from varying backgrounds could mingle easily. Mingle means they should mix easily. But he has here cited the example of his, science teacher, Shiva Subramaniam Iyer, and what he has told, that he was of a rebel sort. You know who are rebels? Who are against the set belief? Are rebels good for society or not? What is your opinion? Are rebels good for society or not? Who never conform to the rules of the society? Yes, Diya?
Ma'am, it depends on the beliefs they are fighting against. For example, in this case, the rebels are good. They are fighting against the orthodox system, segregation system.
Right.
That should not be present.
Okay. Lavlina also raised up hand. Where is Lavlina? Yes, Lavlina, raise up hand again so that I can listen to your views also. Yes, Lavlina.
The rebels, ma'am, if the rebels are occurring because of the differences created between the Hindu and Muslim communities, then the rebels are wrong. Because they create differences and change the mindset of the people against the communities. They should mingle and stay together.
Okay, now tell me, are rebels acceptable by the society? Are rebels acceptable by the society or not?
Ma'am, rebels on what condition? Matlab, kyun ho rahe hain rebels?
People like rebels, or people want to be a rebel or not?
Ma'am, no.
No. Okay, so this is what means. Thing is that rebels who do not conform to the norms of the society, who feel that whatever change or what is the prevalent system, it must undergo a change. Right? These are called as rebels. So as Dia said, it depends upon the situation that what kind of change they want to bring. If it is for good, they are always appreciated. And if they are doing something wrong, or if they are changing the set system, which is going on the right track, which is moving on the right lines, and ultimately they are changing, then ultimately they prove to be, you can say they prove to be disturbing elements in the society, or they are called to be as unsociable and sociable elements. But ultimately, a rebel, nobody wants to be a rebel. It needs a lot of courage to change the system, to stand against the set system, right? So rebels are not easily acceptable by the society, and nobody wants to be a rebel. But his teacher, Shiva Subramaniam Iyer, he was a rebel because he also belonged to Orthodox Brahmin family, and his wife was too conservative. Too conservative means she was totally following the norms of Orthodox Brahmin heritage. She's never allowing a Muslim boy to sit in her house and to, you can say, and to enter their house. But ultimately, Shiva Subramaniam, he is not at all agreeing to all these, you can say, thinkings, or he is not agreeing to all this, what is going on. He wants a change in the society. So he was of a rebel sort. But as he is a rebel, going to change, it is for going to change for the good of the society. So this is the reason why he was called as rebel. So he used to spend hours, he did his best to break social barriers so that people from varying backgrounds could mingle easily. So he was trying his best to mix up various social groups so that the people could sit together and mix together and share, share the things. There should not be any kind of barrier that one should not go there and one should not be acceptable in that social group. It should not be like that. He used to spend hours with me and would say, Kalam, I want you to develop so that you are on par with the highly educated people of the big cities. So he has spotted his potential. He has recognized Kalam's potential. He knew that he was not an ordinary child. He knew that he is a child who, if given proper grooming, if given proper guidance, will bloom into a great flower. So what he said that I want you to be at par. I want to see you at the equal level to that of the educated people of the big cities. He knew that that Rameshwaram is not so developed. There are not enough educational opportunities. Okay, so he wanted that he should be at par with the educated people of the big cities. One day, he invited me to his home for a meal. So he's sharing the next incident. What happened? One day he has invited him to have dinner with him. His wife was horrified at the idea of a Muslim boy being invited to dine at her ritually pure kitchen. Her wife, she was red with anger. What? You have invited a Muslim boy and he would come and sit in our kitchen, which is pure, which is ritually pure. You know, Brahmins, they are very strict in their traditions. They are not allowing people to bring in their footwear or their chappals into the kitchen. They used to sit onto the floor and have food in the platters. Okay, platter leaves. So she was not at all ready to accept this Muslim boy to enter their kitchen, because she was feeling that there is a lot of difference between Brahmins as well as Muslims. She refused to serve me in her kitchen. She told her husband that she would not allow Abdul Kalam to enter their kitchen and would sit with them. Shiva Subramaniam Iyer, he was not perturbed. He was not at all disturbed. He did not change his mind because of that. Nor did he got angry with his wife. And even he did not get angry with his wife. But instead, he served me with his own hands and sat down beside me to eat his meal. His wife watched us from behind the kitchen door. So what he did, he told his wife, if you are not ready to serve this boy, then I'll do that. Don't worry. So what he did, So he made me sit in the kitchen, and his wife was very angry, and ultimately he served with his own hands and from the same utensils with the same you can serving spoon with which he is getting or which is used for serving for the other family members of the Brahmin family. And his wife, she was just looking at this from the behind the door of the kitchen, that what he is doing. I wondered whether she had observed any difference in the way I ate rice, drank water, or cleaned the floor after the meal. She has observed that there was not any difference. Being a human, because they also have Muslims, they also eat as the Brahmins do. They also drink the water as they do. And moreover, they also clean the floor after the Brahmins do. It means that there is not any difference in their natural habits. Moreover, in the process of cleanliness, they are too clean. When I was leaving his house, Shiva Subramaniam Iyer, he invited me to join him for dinner again the next weekend. So he actually, what he wanted to start is that to break the tradition, to break the set tradition that a Muslim boy should not enter a Brahmin family or Brahmin's house. So he has changed that tradition. Next weekend, he has also invited the boy to come and to have dinner with them. So what happened? When I was leaving his house, he invited me again, observing my hesitation. But APJ Abdul Kalam, he was hesitant. Okay, why he was in hesitation? Because he knew that his wife was not happy because of his coming into the house. She was not ready to serve him in his kitchen, but he has gone against the set traditions. He told me not to get upset, saying, once you decide to change the system, such problems have to be confronted. Confronted means faced. So before, while he was going home, he told him, he has given him a message. What message? He said, once you have decided to change the system, at one point, if you are determined and if you are focused to change the system, then such problems have to be confronted. You will face these kind of problems on and off. There will be many obstacles in your path and many hurdles, but the thing is that you have to cross those hurdles, and moreover, you have to pass on those obstacles. So Shiva Subramaniam Iyer's wife took me inside her kitchen and served me food with her own hands. So she took finally the next time see the change in her wife. So Shiva Subramaniam Iyer, he wanted to change the system from his home. First of all, he wanted to reform his home only. Then next afterwards, his society. So he has started to bring a change right from his home. And ultimately what he said, next time when he went to his home, his wife, she has served with her own hands to this Muslim boy. So see the change that he wanted to bring. And ultimately he was successful in bringing that change. Then the Second World War was over and India's freedom was imminent. Okay, so after Second World War, now India's freedom, it was sure that it will be given. Indians will build their own India, declared Gandhiji. And Gandhiji, what he declared, that India will build their own India, in which everyone will have the right to make their dreams come true, whatever they have seen for long years. The whole country was filled with an unprecedented means unparalleled, incomparable, unprecedented optimism. And I asked my father for permission to leave Rameshwaram and study at the district headquarters in Ramanandpuram. So he was also filled with the same zeal, APJ Abdul Kalam, that he will also attain higher education so that he can put his share in the development of the country. So what he said, I asked my father for permission so that I can leave Rameshwaram and go to Ramananthapuram, where I can study and I can get my higher education. But to that, what was the reaction of the parents? Were parents ready? Was his mother ready? And was his father ready? So let us read further. Yes. He told me as if thinking aloud, Abdul, I know you have to go away to grow. Does the seagull not fly across the sun alone and without a nest? Now he has given an example. So he has justified his leaving of Rameshwaram. His father, he said, I know you have to go away. I know that you have to go away as you have a grown-up boy. Does the seagull not fly? Seagull is a bird, okay, which used to fly over the sea in order to catch fishes, right? So he said, does the seagull fly across the sun alone and without a nest? Seagull is flying alone in the sun, means near the sun, because in the sea, the sun used to appear. It is a part of the sea, okay? And it is living without any nest. He quoted Khalil Gibran to my hesitant mother. So he has also given the example of Khalil Gibran's words to his mother, who was hesitant to send his boy to study at Ramananthapuram. So what he has told, your children are not your children, remember. So what he wanted to give the example through the words of Khalil Gibran, that nothing is yours in this world. You are just means, you are just mediums for their growth in order to take care of them. And ultimately, everyone is free to do whatever he wants. So what he wanted to deliver is, your children are not your children. They are the sons and daughters of life's longing for itself. So what he said, your children are actually not your children. You are just the mediums to make them grow, to take care of them. They are the sons and daughters of life's longing for itself. They are actually the sons and daughters of life itself. They have their dreams. They have their strong affirmations. They have their strong aspirations, and which they have to follow. They come through you. You are the medium to give them birth. You are the source to give them birth. You are the reason why they have come into this world. But not from you. But this doesn't mean that whatever you will say, they will follow it. You may give them your love, but not your thoughts. You may give them, you will nurture them. You can say make them grow. You will take care of them. You can say tend their thought with your love, but it doesn't mean that you will impose your thoughts on them. And this doesn't mean that whatever your thoughts are, they will adapt only those thoughts, for they have their own thoughts, because they also have their own thoughts, and these thoughts they have in their mind, and they have to pursue their thoughts. They have their thoughts, they have their dreams, and ultimately they have to pursue those dreams and those thoughts. And for this reason, we don't have any right to stop or to make Abdul Kalam stay here with us, because he has his dreams. He wanted to achieve some higher, and he has to leave this place. And even he has given the example that even the seagull is not living here. Is living without any nest, but still the bird exists. This doesn't mean that you are bound to a place, you are fixed to a place. You can go anywhere you want in order to pursue your dreams. So this last paragraph, it is also an example of, you can say, innate wisdom that his father has. As in the starting of the chapter, it is said that APJ Abdul Kalam's father, he's endowed with innate wisdom. Yes, of course, this is the example that how he has made his mother ready to agree to the thinking of APJ Abdul Kalam. how he got ready to allow him to go to Ramananthapuram in order to attain higher education. And this is what this chapter is all about APJ Abdul Kalam Azad. So we have come to know that life is not always bed of roses. One has to go through all kinds of hardships, all kinds of difficult times in order to achieve the limitless horizon and in order to be the ruler of the world. He has turned out to be the president of India, but he has faced many kind of hardships his life, or he was not destined to be the president forever. He has lived a very simple life. He has faced many difficulties. He also felt shortage of money in his life. This is the reason why he knew what is the meaning of progress. So this was giving him push to progress further. And that's all about the chapter. And I hope that you have enjoyed it a lot. Very informative chapter in which many facts they are being disclosed, and you have also learned, you can say, good values from it, not to discriminate, not to spread communal intolerance, and be a man of simple living and high thinking, and always be progressive. And you should not be an obstacle in the path of anybody if he wants to achieve something. This is all about the chapter. And tomorrow we will continue with the discussion of the question answers of this chapter. And now I'm going to take your doubts. If you have any doubts, you can raise up your hands so that I can answer them.